Hello friends of Oak Hills, this is Pastor Dale coming to you with our weekly video touch point. Today is Thursday, September 1st, 2022. For our Points to Ponder article today, I'm starting a new series called The Big Story of the Bible. This is part one, the prequel, God's Eternal Covenant. I heard recently a speaker compare reading The Lord of the Rings with reading the Bible. He said that no one randomly opens the Two Towers and starts reading profitably without understanding the overarching storyline and the particulars of the context of the portion he is reading. He contends the same is with reading the Bible. The Apostle Paul says that the Bible is profitable and equips the person of God for every good work in 2 Timothy 3:16 and 17. But familiarity with the big story of the Bible is essential for maximizing the profitableness of Bible reading. How familiar are you with the overarching story of the Bible? Let's dive into the big story of the Bible over these next few weeks. It all starts at the beginning. Well, it actually starts before the beginning. Most people are familiar with the opening words of the Bible. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, Genesis 1:1. We find in the Bible, however, that God was active even before creating the heavens and the earth. This, of course, assumes a chronological order of events in the storyline. God is not subject to such chronology since he is eternal and outside of time. We will have to save such mind-splitting theology for another Touchpoint series. While God is not subject to chronological order, he does work out his plan of redemption in a logical order, which we as creatures experience in the chronology of world history. In his closing benediction, the writer of Hebrews speaks about the eternal covenant in Hebrews 13:20. A covenant is an agreement between two parties. Since humans are not eternal, humans cannot be party to an eternal covenant. Also, since creation has a beginning point, this eternal covenant must predate creation. Since God is the only being who predates creation, this eternal covenant must be an agreement among the persons of the Trinity. This leads us to Jesus' high priestly prayer in John 17, where he speaks about completing certain obligations of some agreement with the Father. Consider verse 4 and 5. I glorified you on earth, having accomplished the work that you gave me to do. And now, Father, glorify me in your own presence with the glory that I had with you before the world existed. The Son had a job to do in human flesh on earth. The Father made promises to the Son that were fulfilled once the job was accomplished. The Apostle Paul gives further details about this agreement between the Father and the Son. He says in 2 Timothy 1:9, God saved us and called us to a holy living, not because of our works, but because of his own purpose and grace, which he gave us in Christ Jesus before the ages began. Our salvation, or redemption, is caused not by anything we have done, but by God's purpose and grace. The last clause of the verse, however, draws our attention to the eternal covenant. God gives us the grace of redemption in Christ Jesus before the ages began, which is another way to speak about before the creation. In the agreement between God the Father and God the Father promises to redeem a people, conforming them to the image of the Son, Romans 8:29, to the praise of his glorious grace, Ephesians 1:6. A redeemed people glorifies the Son. This is the prayer of Jesus in John 17, verse 5. We are familiar with this redemption. The word redemption speaks about a purchase or even a buying back. So a price must be paid. Paul says the redemption price is only the blood of Jesus in Ephesians 1:7. Therefore, we can understand that the main part of the work Jesus accomplished in his earthly ministry is offering himself on the cross as the redemption price. The eternal covenant of Hebrews 13 is often called the covenant of redemption. The Father and the Son make an agreement and plan before the creation of the world to redeem a people who will glorify the Son for all eternity. This helps us as we read our Bibles to understand that we are reading the outworking of God's plan or covenant of redemption. Everything that happens is part of that big story of redemption. Everything we read in the Bible ties into the overarching story. We should read our Bibles looking for those clues that tie it all together in the covenant of redemption. A few highlights to touch on today to draw your attention to, as it is a new month. We have a new missionary of the month, and this month we are focusing on Chase and Shaw Johnson, who serve with Surge in Cluj, Romania. They are part of an outreach team that is seeking to minister to university students and the arts community. They have some new team members that are joining them, and their prayer is a request for the team to continue to build and to grow in unity together in their ministry efforts. Pray for their touch points with people in the community as they seek to share Christ. Cluj, Romania has been more impacted by the pandemic than we have experienced here in the Kansas City region. So they're still just coming out of many restrictions on how that has impacted their outreach to different people in the community. We were privileged to have Chase and Shaw visit us earlier this summer in the end of June as they were visiting back in the States. It was good to visit with them. I had coffee. Pastor John and I met with them for coffee, and it was good to catch up with them. They're doing well. They do ask for prayer regarding just next steps as they look ahead to the future. They are aging. They've been in Cluj, Romania for over 20 years, and they're prayerfully considering what does ministry look like in the next steps or the next stages of their life, even as they think about what retirement looks like for them. Secondly, our Sunday school resumes in two Sundays on September 11th. We will be holding classes for most ages of children and for our adults. There's details in our touch point and in the bulletin. We encourage you to plan to join us on September 11th at 9:30. Woody Jeffrey will be teaching our adult class focused on discipleship and what it means to be a disciple of Jesus Christ. Also, in the month of September, we are going to open up officer nominations. So our members of our church have the opportunity and the responsibility to identify men who are in our midst, who are serving faithfully and have been matured enough in their faith and their walk with the Lord to serve the church as an officer, either as a deacon or as an elder. The elders are the shepherds of the congregation, the overseers who oversee the mission and vision of the church and the ministry of teaching and preaching and the ministry of sacraments. Our deacons are the ministers of mercy, seeking to care for physical and even emotional needs of people in their distress. And so if you're a member of the church, we encourage you to use this month to prayerfully consider who in our midst might be serving and might be God is working in their lives to serve in this way. And please use our nomination forms that will be available at the church to submit those names for that process. Our sister church, Redeemer Presbyterian Church in Southern Overland Park, is holding an introduction to biblical counseling class this fall that will meet on Monday evenings, and it begins on September 12th. So if you are interested in receiving training in how to use scripture to encourage and exhort fellow brothers and sisters in the Lord to build them up in Christ, this is an excellent opportunity, a class for you to be equipped with those kind of tools. Biblical counseling simply is Christian love, care for one another, using the text of scripture to exhort and build up one another. And for our men and women, there are unique opportunities. For our men, there is a hiking trip in the middle of this month, leaving on Thursday, September 15th, going to Colorado and hiking in the Rocky Mountains. And for our women, the fall Bible studies have launched already, but it's not too late to get plugged in and be a part of that. They just did an introduction and overview of their curriculum. They will meet again this next week. They meet on Wednesday mornings or Thursday evenings. There's more details in the touch point and the bulletin. We encourage our men and women to be plugged in and connected in one way or another with other people of the church. And two more items here in our highlights. If you are coming to the church this weekend, you'll be pleasantly happy to see that the pavement of the road is complete. Goddard Street is fully paved. The final asphalt has been laid, and our parking spots have returned in front of the building. That has all been filled in and paved there. There will still be finishing work to be done, landscaping and the final touches of the work that will continue by the church. And so look for that and be happy to be driving on a smooth new road there on Goddard Street coming into the church. And then lastly, this Sunday we come back to Daniel, and I'll be looking in Daniel chapter 9, where Daniel turns to the Lord in prayer. And this is one of the beautiful teaching lessons on prayer in Scripture. And I pray that it would sharpen us, encourage us, inspire us to be people of prayer, and help us to be stretched in our own prayer life. I've never met a Christian who hasn't felt like they could not grow in their prayer life. And so this is a great focus and great attention here in Daniel chapter 9. I hope you're able to join us. Well, thank you for joining me today for our weekly touch point. We hope to see you soon. God bless.